ってみて。
I would like to call upon Dr. Suresh Chandra Pani, Director BIIB, to welcome our guest with a bouquet. May we now call upon Utkarsh Tyagi, Student Manager, Balaji Institute of International Business, to introduce our guest.
A very good afternoon to one and all present here. I, Utkarsh Tyagi, Student Manager, Balaji Institute of International Business, feel honored to introduce amongst us Ms. Rachna Bharat, Head of HR, State Street Central Services Private Limited. In addition to functions of HR, ma'am has over 15 years of experience in managing employee relations, human capital development, recruitment, selection and driving strategic change management initiatives. Ma'am has worked for several other organizations such as WLS Global Services as Senior Group Manager HR, WLS Global Services as Associate Vice President HR, Head Learning and Development, Service Assurance and Communication ASL. Ma'am, we are highly privileged to have you again amongst us. Now, I would like you to enlighten us with your words of wisdom. The stage is all yours. Thank you.
So, a very good afternoon to all of you. How is it going so far?
Very good.
I'm really happy to be here, and it's really, I really feel proud to see all the young bucket people sitting here, and it's really amazing. And as I understand that we have this topic or the main core theme of what we have as a theme for this convention is business challenges, the dynamic business environment and the challenges associated with it, right? So this is what I have. I will share my perspective and I will share my views around what I have with me. I don't want to stand here and tell you a lot of stuff. I don't think I would want to do that. As far as knowledge is concerned, in my view, there might be people and collective knowledge in this room may be a lot larger than what I possess. Am I right?
Yes,
ma'am. However, and if I look at my experience, yes, I do have 19 years of work experience, and probably there might be, that's one thing which I may have to share with you. But again, if I talk about the collective experience in this room, probably maybe higher than mine as well. Right? So I think the power lies there, all of you. That's where the power lies. So I would want this to be a discussion wherein I would want all of you to interact. And I would like to hear from most of you. Please voice out your views, your opinions, rather than hearing mine, because that's what I would want this session to be like. So, as far as you know, the topic concerns challenges in the dynamic business environment. So, if I look around and if I ask you, and I would want some mics to around, because I want to hear from people here and rather than me speaking. So do we have mics around? We do have it. So I would want to hear from all of you. Do business dynamics constantly change, or is change in business dynamics constant? What do you guys feel?
Change
is
constant.
B. A or B?
B.
Change in business dynamics constant, right? No?
Yes.
Okay, raise your hands. How many of you feel A? Alright, there are people who feel A. How many of you feel B? Wow, that's amazing. Now I would want to hear from somebody who raised their hands on A as to why do they feel what they feel. Can I hear your views? Why do you think Do business dynamics constantly change? Why do you feel A is the option? Anybody from the group who said A? I'm not picking on you guys, but then it's just for the benefiting of all of us. Let's just hear your views. Do you have anybody who raised their hand, says A, and would want to express as to why do they feel that the business dynamics constantly change? Yeah? All right. Can I have the hands up again of people who feel all right. We have?
Changing, like earlier it was not so social environment, but now presently if we say if we see that, environment is more social, like emerging of social sites and Jantra, these all are such dynamic environments which we are facing at present.
Alright, okay. So again, so as we say, so business dynamics are constantly changing. There is a view in the group, but then largely we feel that change in business dynamics is constant. So let's like kind of go ahead. And how many of you listen to music?
Yes.
Again, I picked up this because I felt that music is something we most of us associate very easily with. If you're not singing, at least we are listening to, or at least that's something which keeps pouring in our ears, right? So if you actually look at the business dynamics, and if you look at the way things move, have you seen the way the music industry changed? Right? How many of you have seen LPs in your life? Oh wow. One, two, three, few more. Yes. How many of you have seen Walkmans? Amazing. Large chunk, I would say. Now, of course, I should not say how many of you listen to MP3s. I'm sure all of you do. Now, do you see that how the business dynamics are... generally what happens is in the music industry, when
researchers get together, even competitors and the researchers, they all get together and then they discuss as to what they're researching on, what their progress is like and what these guys are doing about. Sony, when they came up, they could not come up with anything different than vinyls. They had the compact disc or the smaller version of that. That did not become a breakthrough. I think what became more innovative is cassettes. Have you guys seen those cassettes?
Yes.
Right? That was, and then the Walkmans, and then etc., and then that stayed on. So the journey continues there, and MP Man nobody has heard of. Right? When I asked people, but they were actually the first portable digital audio player by South Korean and whatever the systems were. They were the first one to do it. So if I link it back to the innovation, these were the guys who really innovated. So ideally, they should have got the first mover's advantage.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, we all talk about that, right? First mover's advantage, hey, here I get it. But then that's not how it is. But then how you kind of link it up with the industry and how you move along and the dynamics, the way it changes, there are times we don't understand that. There are times we don't fathom that. And hence, that continues. So I will continue further. Then of course you guys have heard of iPod.
Yes, ma'am.
Right? Now tell me, and I would want you guys to all ponder another thing, and I'm linking it back to the question which we started on in the beginning. The dynamism in the business environment is something which is constant. Take any industry, take yourself, take the way we study now to what we've been doing. There is something which is constant, and we all keep saying that is change. It applies to anything and everything, guys. So there is no rule which doesn't apply to. It applies to the business environment. It applies to you and me. I was walking back with one of your fellow students, and I was just talking, and they were saying that, yes, I am not what I was when I was in 11th standard. I'm not who I was when I was in, like, 10 years back. Same applies to the industry. Same applies to whatever you and I are doing. So this is just an example that the business dynamics will keep changing. The business dynamics will keep moving on what you and I are talking about right now. So again, this is what we are talking about, right? Challenges of business. Is it really a challenge? Is it really a challenge? What is a challenge? Change is a challenge? Adapting to change is a challenge? So, dynamism in the business environment, is that a challenge or adapting to the change is a challenge? So here, the reason why I'm not giving you a lot of those, you know, the bookish words, and I'm just throwing back a perspective to all of you that what we call as a challenge is actually not a challenge. It is a reality. It is a reality of the business. Things will keep changing. What you and I are discussing today and talking about as a big challenge, you know, big data, Hadoop, that becomes a challenge. Tomorrow, you and I will be sitting maybe after 2 years, and the challenges which we will be talking about will be very different. So, business dynamics, is that a challenge? Not really. That's a reality. Let's wake up to the reality. Isn't that so? So, here I wanted to give you a perspective of looking at that, is that really a challenge? Rather than saying that challenges in the business dynamics, don't we be saying that it's a reality of, you know, the business or dynamism it carries, right? So here I wanted to leave you with the perspective of the challenges is not, or the limitations which are posed is not by that the change or the dynamism we carry in the business, but rather how we adapt or how much are we aware of that challenges and how we are coping up with it. And that's the perspective I want you all to leave with as you move along with it. And I will give you a little bit reality, again, not a challenge, of how the business. There are a few components of the business reality or what we call as the business environment. Market. That was there, that is there, that will be there. Correct? We have competition as a change that will be there, that was there, that is there. Similarly, we have operations, regulators, we have people. These components which actually form any business environment is there, but then what keeps changing is the nuances between that. Isn't that so? Right? These things are there, the realities are there. But what will we keep changing is that who are our customers? The way, the needs of the customer, etc., that's what keeps changing. Our competition will keep changing. Right? Our operations, our regulations, what exists today may not exist in a similar way and form. That will keep changing. So, your business dynamics, what changes in the parameters which actually define your business dynamics, and what the realities which we will change is these few components of what we talk about. Feel free to add your views, feel free to voice out your opinions, and feel free to speak up if you have any questions around any of it. We don't have to wait till the end for any question answer sessions. If you have anything. Any thoughts, any views? All right, if nothing, then I will just move along with it. Now, and another perspective which I wanted to give you as far as the business dynamics are, there are times when we say that we need to know what our customers want, right? That's what we keep saying. Have you heard that?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it true?
Yes, ma'am.
Do customers really know what they want?
No, ma'am.
Excuse me, ma'am.
There is some, excuse me, I heard, yes.
Ma'am, change is constant. We are well aware of that. But the rate at which it is changing is a concern for us. So how should we tackle that?
I'm sorry,
change is the only constant is what we are aware of. That change has to be there, change has to be challenging as well. But at the same point, the rate at which it is changing now, when you see 60 years back, one innovation, then 20 years, there was a gap. Now what is happening is that one innovation, next year, there's disruptive innovation happening again. So how do we as managers tackle that?
All right. Thank you so much. And that's a very good question. So again, I'm sorry, what's your name? Suraj. Sumit, I'm sorry. Well, Sumit here posed a very, very relevant question as to change is happening, right? But then the way change was happening before and the frequency of that change of what used to happen before and the way it is happening now, it's different. Yeah, we all see that. But then what was the definition of change any which ways? What was the definition of a frequency of change any which ways? Change is a change, right? I'll come back to your question. But the perspective which I wanted to draw in here is that at that point in time also, people, when you go back and ask them, is the change really challenging them? They would say, oh my God, what the world we are living in. It's crazy. The way things are changing, what it was and what it is. And these are the words which you'll keep hearing. Now, how do we cope up with that? But the only thing is that, yes, probably we are feeling that the change now is very frequent, right? For us, the frequency, the definition of frequency, what? Probably a year, a month? What would be that?
Give an example.
So see, if I,
Big Basket, now Big Basket is there, they've started their operations, next year someone else comes up, there's Swiggy. So there's immense competition. So how does, if I am Big Basket or if we are tackling such a scenario, how do we as managers take decisions and tackle?
Alright, so again, I will come back. So again, the point which I wanted to draw is that the frequency of the change is reduced a lot. Maybe if I need to say that frequency of the change maybe is a year now, earlier than maybe 20 years or maybe 2 years or whatever. Now that frequency, when I go back, go again in future, probably that frequency would be a month. Probably, right? And then the question of a challenge would be, how do I cope up now? So that question will always exist. Now, if I go back to the current scenario and the current set of schemes, the things are changing maybe at the frequency, the competition is coping up. The awareness, what's happening, how my competition is doing, what is needed, and again, can I think differently? Can I bring about something which is maybe which can become a USP? Can I think of something different? Again, if I go back to the music industry example, how many of us, while we were using cassettes or CDs, really thought that live streaming would be a reality? Did we think?
No.
Not really, right? But somebody did. That somebody who did made the success. So can we be that somebody who can think? Think beyond the boundaries, can bring up that innovativeness, and can bring about that change. So there are two set of leaders. Can all of us sitting in this room, I'm giving a reality check to all of it. How many of us would be sitting out and being innovative and day in and day out? What percentage? Roughly? 2%, 0.5, 1%, it is not 100% by any which means. The answer which I wanted to get. Can all of us be innovators? We can be. I am not saying we can't be. We can be. And that's again a challenge which we, that no saying, you know, is another thing which we tell ourselves that no, we can't be, hence we can't be. I think all of those who are saying that yes, we can be are actually innovating. So again, that's again for you to think that do you want to be or don't you want to be? If you really, it's all about training your mind. If you really think that yes, I want to innovate, I will be. And again, I will give you a very real-time example, Sumit and the gang. And this thing which I see in the industry, I was talking to the colleagues, right? People say 19 years of work experience, 20 years of work experience, that becomes a hindrance sometimes. Because we only like to see things in that specific manner. That was happening to Sony. They could not come up with cassettes. They could get a smaller version of compact discs probably, but they could not innovate cassettes because they could not think. At times our experience creates those boundaries and hindrances for ourselves. So we constantly need to, as leaders, we need to constantly keep unlearning, keep understanding, and keep innovating and see that how innovation doesn't mean that I create something very, very different and new. As leaders, we need to see how do I do things differently, because how it fitted in 5 years back may not fit in this business environment. And a lot of us see that experience is the teacher. I said, no, newness. How do I do things differently? Unlearn my old experience, still apply my wisdom. I get my wisdom from my experience, but I cannot apply the same method all the time. I need to apply new methods. I need to apply newness to it. Maybe the wisdom which I carry and I get out of that experience, I apply, but there has to be the same tailor-made thing may not apply. And that applies to and not alone now. Though we say the changing dynamic work environment, it's the frequency has reduced. That would apply to, if you talk to your father and forefathers, they will say, oh my God, it was very challenging. Then in our worlds, we struggled and only 100 rupees we earned and you guys are making big moolah. You know, you would hear all those things. So the challenges will continue. And if you talk to your future generation, they say, what? You guys, what are changes were only once in 2 years. Now it happens every second day for us. They have to cope up then as well. So my point is that how we keep looking at things with that newness and how we keep thinking that, yes, I can innovate. Don't let that thing creep in your head that you can't. And innovation doesn't mean that creating something very new, as all of us have the power to create something new in our own capacity. You need to identify that specific capacity for yourself and apply it. We all carry the wisdom. We just need to see how we apply it. I hire a lot of new hires and freshers, and trust me, many of us, again, that's the belief we carry within ourselves, say that, hey, I don't have experience, I don't know how to apply it. But you all have it. You just need to realize and tell yourself, how do I move along, and then do it. People, like even those who innovated, and I think most of you here acknowledge the fact customers also don't know what they want. We didn't know what live streaming is what we want. But now when it's here with us, we love it. We don't even know, we are happy with it, aren't we?
Yes.
Right? We don't know what will come tomorrow. We'll be happy with that as well. But people who are innovating, they're not limiting to that. They're coming up with the new thoughts, they're coming up with the new ideas. Keep thinking new. Don't let yourself settle down for that. So that's the key, guys. That's the key in this dynamic environment. When I look back in the leaders, and when I even look back at my things, in the kind of challenges which we come across, the challenges which I face in the human resources, right, not very different than what I would probably be facing before. Can I apply the same solution what I applied 10 years back? Probably not. If I do that, I would fail. Right? So that is what you guys need to keep answering. And there is no solution. A speaker standing here cannot give you that solution. They can give you a set perspective. How many of you have heard Khalil Gibran? Have you read Prophet?
Yes, ma'am.
Right? Few of you have. So in Prophet he says, I can only teach you what you already know. People can only teach you what you already know. Isn't it amazing? I already know it. So again, there are things which we already know it, but then we don't know how to exploit it, how to bring it forth, how do we take it ahead. And trust me, the dynamic business environment, when we talk it today, talk of it yesterday, there have been people who've been successful. I'll talk about a couple of, I'll just move ahead and I'll just give you a little bit of, a little more perspective to various companies, right? I'm not the first one whom you are hearing this from, that Fortune 500 firms in 1955, 90% of them are not there anymore. This is not the first time you're hearing this. Correct? You heard this before. But then there are some who are consistent. IBM is still there, Whirlpool, Boeing. The companies are still there. Isn't it?
Yes.
And then there are breakthroughs. Microsoft, eBay, McDonald's. So my point is, and more so over, what makes companies?
People.
Employees.
Isn't it? Right? We talk about companies here. We don't talk about those people who we don't have those names there. Right? There is a possibility that some of them would have been working with American Motors, probably then to IBM, and then created something in McDonald's, hypothetically. But I'm saying that even though organization, 90% of it may not exist today, and they were Fortune 500, as an individual, as leaders, we just need to see how effective we are in the given situation and the given dynamic situations and the circumstances. Right? Things will keep moving, things will keep changing. Where we want to be, where do we place ourselves? Where do we want to be? And what is that which is making and breaking the change? So, a lot of it lies on us. What is everything? So, disruption is the norm. We have to accept it. It's not a challenge, it's a reality. It is a reality. Disruption is a reality. And if you can create it yourself, that's what makes you feature on the breakthroughs. So, isn't it? When you're creating disruption yourself and creating newness is what gets you there. And there are people who are going along with the disruption, maybe disruption caused by the environment. They're sustaining, they're consistent, they're innovating, they're going along. But then, if you are creating disruptions for yourself, for the organization, that's when the breakthroughs happen. Right? again. So it is again, and these are opportunities, these are not challenges. Not at all a challenge. Because in my view, what does challenge do to all of us? Either we succumb to it, then it has killed us. Otherwise, if we have overcome it, where does it take us? What do challenges make us realize that we can move along or away or beyond our limitations? Isn't that what challenges do to you? So challenges are opportunities, guys. It is not a limitation. Challenges are there to make you realize that there are limitations which you can go beyond. And that's why it's an opportunity. Which side of the wall you want to be? Disruption is a reality. How do I live with it? What do I do? What are my coping mechanisms? There is no tailor-made answer for that. That'll be different for you, that'll be different for you, and that'll be different for you. You need to ask yourself, how do I cope up with it? And if you start, I mean, you can get perspective and keep increasing your perspectives by getting more knowledge, getting more experience, understanding, listening to people, etc. That will give you the perspective and enlarge or larger perspectives, give larger coping mechanism or overcoming that challenge. But then the answer lies with you, all of you. And the answer would be very unique to all of you. So I wanted to... I'm not here to give you any solution. I will not give you any. Because my solutions work for me, may not work for you. So my coping mechanisms work for me, may not work for you. Yes, I can give you, I can share, maybe some bit of it you can apply. But then my point is, you need to see that how that challenge is becoming an opportunity and how which side of the fence we are on. Alright? So, and the strategy, this coping strategy, what I create today, may not just apply tomorrow. It will be so different. That's what we talked about, right? Is it making sense?
Yes, ma'am.
Any thoughts? Any thoughts? All right. So keep your thoughts, even if you have thoughts, it's good. Even whether you're sharing it or not, that's secondary. But if you have thoughts, and if it is giving you some stimuli and some thoughts, I think my job is done. So that's why I just wanted to say that, take that as an opportunity. I think, I have a very different perspective to leadership. I have a very different perspective to, I know we can give it different names, digital leadership, etc. But my view is that it all lies in an individual and how we cope up and how we move along with it. But then as we talk about certain, and you know, how do we manage that, sustain and grow, managing growth. Yeah. As I said, keep innovating, keep rebalancing. How do I get that what? In the current given scenarios, how I can still do things differently and move along with it. Right? Then you have your customer engagement. Whatever is available, as we all know, that customer may not know, but then yes. At least whatever is to sustain, to grow, will have to do things very differently. But to sustain, I need to continuously keep knowing that if it is not working, like we spoke about MP Man, right? That was the first mover. They just couldn't live in the market at all. First mover advantage. They just didn't get it because they didn't know whether it will work or no. They just didn't click. So, again, for grow, you need to continuously keep rethinking models. You have to continuously see that what is that which we need to do. Keep rethinking. Keep doing that, keep establishing yourself. So that's what is something which, and innovation. 100% of you can innovate, guys. But the definition of innovation may vary. So again, I didn't want to give a lot of, slider on a lot of stuff, but this is what it is. And I will leave it now to all of you. If you have any questions, anything which you want to share, because I think, as I said, that collective knowledge and collective experience in this group is huge. I'm sure. non-inconvenience as well. So, any thoughts, any questions, any views? Yes. Can you have a mic there?
Good afternoon, ma'am. I'm Priyadarshini Singh from BIMM. First of all, ma'am, thank you so much for making us aware about the change, challenges and reality of business dynamics. Ma'am, according to a report, it is observed that around 1/3 of the total workforce will change job in every 12 months. And ma'am, few months just down the line, you would enter the corporate world. And to be honest, it's challenging for both. Be it organization, they spend a lot in training and development, and for an employee. It's very challenging to, you know, to enter a new environment, new workforce, new colleagues, and sometimes new work. So, based on at what point of time or based on what parameters, we should decide that it's the right time to switch a company, and if yes, then how?
All right. Okay. Before I even start the career, I'm thinking of when to switch the company is... okay, thank you so much. If I get your question right, you are asking that how the, as 1/3 of the population is like fast moving and the churn is very high in the industry.
Our research also says that most of the switches are in first and second years only. When they, you know, in the first and second job. After that, they become little constant in their work.
Right, so probably the wisdom grows in...
Yeah, after experience of
yeah. All right. So again, what you want to know is that when one should decide or think to switch the job, if need be. Have I got your question right?
I'm salary not being the only factor.
Salary not being the only factor. All right. So I will try and answer that. It's a very again a very individualistic answer. But all I would say is that you can please sit down. You can ask the question while sitting as well. So, and few of you would have experienced, you have experience, okay. So, few of you already have experience, and then now you're doing your MBAs and further studies and various, so there was a reason, right, that you chose to do what you do. That is a calling, what you say that this is what I want to do, this is here I want now, and hence you kind of move on. But when I talk about, like we spoke about customers, they don't know, right? Who are customers? Human beings, you and me, correct? Similarly, our people who are working in the organizations, as you rightly are saying, people move in, there are times when people are experimenting. And people just kind of getting into the organization, they're experimenting, and then they feel that this is not working, and then they move on, and then this happens in the first or two jobs, as you rightly are saying, because they're experimenting mode is on. And then they say, either two of the things can happen. The one thing is that they realize that I think it was not worth it to experiment the way they did. It is causing, it's harming them more than benefiting. And then they say, all right, now settle it. Or they find the real passion or where they belong. But most of them really don't follow that passion path, what I've seen. So they would just be experimenting. However, a piece of, I can use the word advice for short of any better word. When we are experimenting also, don't give in too soon. I have seen that when people hired, we have a very, I have seen people when we hire specifically from campuses or even when they move the freshers, etc. There is a very different world, or the picture of that world is very different when they get into the corporate. But the realities are very different when they get into the corporate. And hence, again the same thing, the challenges, not being able to cope up to that, and ability or inability to unlearn kicks in. Because they have the certain picture which they created, and then they move in, the picture which they are living in, this is a different world. They didn't want to be here, and then they move on. They move on another place, and they say, all right, probably the realities out there would be different, and then they realize, no, it's the same. And then they move on, and then they probably learn to cope up and say, here we are, that's the reality and that's where I need to be. So I'm saying to all of you, a piece of advice, don't give in too soon. The moment you start facing challenges in the corporate world, take that as an opportunity. Learning is an ongoing process. You will keep learning from those challenges. And you and I are learning every day, every moment. So keep that learning process on. Because the moment your learning process is on, you will keep learning, you will keep absorbing, you will keep innovating, you will keep doing things differently because you want to excel and do more. The thought, don't let that thought of that I need to quit and move on because these challenges. You know, if life has thrown you, as I say, you know, if life has given you a lemon, make lemonade out of it, right? So do that. So don't quit so soon. Give it at least good enough time, at least 2 years for you to adapt to it, for you to learn to it, and then see if it is making sense for you or no. Maybe 2 to 3 years is a good time for you to know the reality of things. That, I hope that answers. Anything else? Anybody else has? Can't hear her.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi.
Actually, this is changing constantly. There's also changing technology that keeps happening. So even if a company has invested in like a machine which is expensive as a capital expenditure, how do you, because since every 6 months or 1 year there's a new machine coming up. So the machine becomes absolute at a very quicker rate compared to what the life period is. So how do you think the company should be taking decisions on those bases, actually?
All right. So so what you're saying is, so actually it's not the, it's probably not the machine which is changing, the software inside it which is changing, right? So we can always upgrade it. No, but yeah, I get your question. So here, what you're saying is that which technology and what do I invest in that it may just change tomorrow, right? So when we are taking that call and when we are deciding that as an organization, when we think about, we always think about scalability, right? Because again, as I said, knowing the reality is change. It will, what I'm doing in today may change. Similarly, the investments which I'm making in today in the technology or in whatever we are doing is gonna change. So we constantly, when we invest in things, for example, largely in the IT world and in the technology field, etc., we invest in stuff on the technology and we constantly keep checking the market, the environment, what's happening, what's new to be needs to be done, how differently it will be from now on. And then the scalability is one bit of it we keep in mind when we invest in anything. And not alone it applies to, and I will move, I digress a little from, because here you spoke about machines and you know, my passion for automobiles. So again, if you look at the automobiles and the engineering out there, right? Things keep changing, right? We have DSI engines now, which was not there before, correct? So things, that doesn't mean that, so all things do become obsolete slowly. It will. So again, we will have to keep, that doesn't mean that we don't invest in, but again, the scalability and the reality which we have to keep in mind is an objective which we have to constantly keep in mind. But another thing which I wanted to and digress, move on is, it doesn't alone apply in lot of machines and equipments and that kind of a thing, and technology the way it is. The scalability and the ever-changing environment, when I you know, relate that back, when I'm applying different models and you know, in the with human beings as well, because that's my larger human capital is what we work with largely, not with machines, right? In you and I, which we work with. So when we apply some things out there, one thing which I tell my team, and when we apply anything, scalability is one thing we always keep in mind, and how we can apply technology, and even if the technology changes tomorrow, how my model will still not go obsolete, and is scalable. With minute little changes, I can maybe move up. I don't have to throw my entire stuff out and get a new one. Rather, I can tweak and move and make few changes, and still it will not be obsolete. Is again a thought which we should keep in mind while we invest.
Thank you.
or create or do something. I hope that answers. Anything else? Anybody else has anything? It's a girl's show. Yes.
Hello, ma'am. My name is Anushri Kulkarni, and I'm from SBS Finance. I just wanted to ask you that as per the business continuously changing, there are lots of expenditure that's going on. So from a finance point of view, I just wanted to ask that how can we control the expenses that's continuously going on due to the changes in the business?
I'm sorry, how do we control the
expenses? Like, it's continuously going on, the changes in the business. That's why we're incurring lots of expenses. So from a finance point of view, how can we...
All right, so when you say finance, again, is a very huge term. I know you might be an MBA, or you must be doing the finance. All right. So finance would vary very differently for... there might be a definition of finance in the books. But if I talk about, if you look at the finance, when I look at running a business, my P&L statement and how do I cut the expenses out there, or for example, how do I manage expenses, my current expenses as well, you know. So it's a huge, wide term, but if I relate that back to the organization, that's what you probably are interested in. So here again, unless we all are into business to make money, right? And in my P&L statement, my expenses do carry large, I mean, my bottom line matters a lot to me, right? I constantly need to keep working on my top line, but my bottom line also carries a huge, huge, huge weightage because I have huge control on it. So in the current given scenarios and situations, how, again, as I think we asked somebody, how do I make my decisions so that in the ever-going and ever-changing environment, how am I investing in things which don't go obsolete and which are still relevant, at least, you know, for the time being, and I still have little bits of scalability, I can make the usage out of it is one bit of it wherein I see that things don't go obsolete and I don't have to bring in the new investment altogether. And that alone, and if I talk about the industry wherein we work with humans, my large expense is going on to the human capital because that's where we work. In my P&L statement, my huge expense is my wage cost, right? So how do I control that? How do I keep innovating and seeing that? How do I keep bringing that down? How do I cut my expenses around that? So the way it applies to the other stuff, finance is no different than that itself. The way it would apply it, how do I grow, how do I cut expenses, everything more or less, the common sense or the logic applies the same. How do I keep sustaining, how do I keep becoming more relevant by keep bringing about the changes which I need to be, and every business, the different segments and the different sectors, that requirement would be very different, but then how do I still be innovative and keep that thing on is the answer to almost all of it. So,
I'm Divya Parya, I'm from SBS Finance. So, I want to ask that how the changes in the monopolistic market, as the changes depend on not according to the market, because the customers don't have any other option in the monopolistic product. So,
give me an example of the monopolistic product which you referring to. Are we really into the monopolistic environment?
As we talk about the railways or any electricity, also in many cases we have the only products in which there is a role of the only one company. So it depends on the company that whether he want to change in any product or not. So how is it possible in that case?
Okay. So again, if I see, and that's the beauty of when we talk about the dynamic work environment of the business environment, the way. So we actually are not, we are talking about the tough competition, right? That's one of the so-called challenge or the so-called opportunity is what we talk about. Are we really in the monopolistic business environment? Probably not. But then there are certain segments, as you did touch upon, like for example, the electricity or those few of it. But then, can we afford again how the business environment and how the change would apply to it? Right. That's what your question is. Maybe I'm not an expert in those areas, but I will just give you my very personal views on this. That even in the monopolistic environment, things may go obsolete or may not just work at all if the change is not brought about. Even if I talk about the way the electricity board or the way things work, okay, let's take our mailing system, right? That was a monopolistic environment wherein Indian Postal Services was the only way. People didn't think, but now the couriers, now everything, nobody, hardly Indian Postal Services are used. Similarly, in the electricity or those monopolistic world, there is innovation. People are thinking, how do we do things differently? We are thinking of bringing about the nuclear as one of the elements, see that how we can change the energy, and we have explored on the thermal or etc. As I said, I'm not an expert, but then yes, innovation and the change. Can I say that it is the way it was? Probably not. It is still not. There is huge way to change there. Yes, there is. Is it changing? It is. People, I pay my electricity bills online. That was not the case probably 5 years back. Was it? It was not. So is it not changing? Is it not? So people out there, people, and I people who are working in that sectors or segments, it is a challenge for them as well, because they are, I don't know how many of you actually go and pay your housing bills or, if people are not comfortable working with those computers, will they sustain?
No.
They won't, right? So is a change coming in there? Yes. It is changing. We'll have to keep adapting to it. We'll have to keep learning. We'll have to keep moving. So whether it's monopolistic, non-monopolistic change is happening, we'll have to keep adapting to it. If people out there in my government offices can't use computers anymore, they will not be able to be sustained there. So things are different there as well.
Good afternoon, ma'am. My name is Harsh Gupta and I'm from SBS Finance. I have a question. You talked about changes in the technology and in the product. That's true. So when the changes are brought in the market, changes are brought in the organization, so what role does advertising play in that? What does advertising have to do? Means what role it plays actually for bringing the product to the customers, for bringing the value addition in that?
Okay, so what you're asking is, and let me see that if I've got your question right, what you're asking is that in the change and in the changing environment, the new products, the new stuff which is coming into the market.
Which
are coming in the market, and then there is a advertising in the marketing field, and what role do they have, because in the end it's all for the customers.
How they convince the customers that, there is a value addition.
So how the customer is finding the value add, and what role do advertising have to bring about that value add?
Yes, exactly.
To the customers, right?
Yes, exactly. All right.
So is that layer relevant? Advertising, marketing, or whatever you want to call it, is that layer relevant? Yes, it is. Wherever there are customers, wherever there are new things which are being put forth, this layer is very important to share that what is in it for me as a customer. Correct? So when we talk about this, and as we all agreed, or most of us believe, that customer also, there are times, doesn't know what they want. They don't know. Right? So that is when this layer becomes important to carry forward that message that this is what is important, this is what is the value add as customers, and that's where that layer becomes important. And hence the relevance of that layer and how do they take it ahead is, of course, when you're creating something new, any new product, it is not just I'm sitting out there and created something without any non-value add. When the product is created, there are the list of things which are a value add, and that is what how I make this relate to the end customer is what this group comes in the picture, that how do I relate that back. For example, how many of us really needed any advertising, and I'm using the same, again, live streaming is again the same example. We didn't need any, wasn't any advertising group which actually came forth? Not. That was a technology. Technology we have to keep adapting. Yes, I may have an upgrade on my phone and I just may take that. However, for the products, for how the value add and what, because we are creating new, something very new. I was on a WhatsApp and I'm sharing very, very trivial stuff on one of the messages which I saw on WhatsApp of Colgate. And any of you got that WhatsApp message? The way they branded some 10 years back and now? Yeah, so 10 years back, yeah, you saw that? 10 years back, they marketed it saying that coal and salt and such harsh things are not good for your gums and teeth. We should not be using it. That was a product they had, and they created that value, and this group communicated that back. That was some time back. And now they're talking about, they have charcoal-based products, and they're saying how healthy it is for your gums and teeth, and toothpaste mein namak hai, you know, stuff like that. So my point is that, and now that is also getting, this group is making and bringing it back. The group is relevant. We will have to keep communicating it back to the customers. So that's how it is.
I wanted to ask that recently an ad was launched by Ching company, Ching Noodles, that which featured Ranveer Singh. It is budgeted to be 75 crore ad film. It's a 5-minute film. Ma'am, it is recently Ching company launched a ad film which is a 5-minute film with a budget of 75 crore rupees. So how relevant is this expenditure of this kind in this changing environment? How relevant it is?
What do you think? Anybody, what are your thoughts? I would want to, is it really relevant? Spending that kind of an amount, and I think I have finance sitting out there who said that how do I cut my expenses? So what is the group? Do you think it's relevant? Spending that, anybody, and any answer? I think a lot of people think yes. I would want to hear from, why do you think it's relevant?
Yes, ma'am, it is absolutely relevant. Because the money has been spent, 75 crore, is just because of change. They want to change the habits of Indian market about noodles and all. So that is for the change. That's why they are spending the money. Ultimately, we are talking about change, and they want to make change. That's why they spent 75 crore.
All right, so that's one view, that they want to bring about the change, and hence they are spending money. But do we really need to spend money to bring about the change? How many of you have watched Patanjali products? What FMCG? Where do they feature it? Top 5?
Yes, ma'am.
How much money do they really spend on marketing? Who's their model and how much do they charge? So again, it's a very... it's always a debatable thing. What's right and what's wrong on that? What's relevant? What's not relevant? For example, if you ask me, you know, to bring about that change, to communicate that back, we have one way to think that all right, spending money is the only way. Probably not. There are more creative ways. right? And that's what I think I just gave you. I mean, I don't think Patanjali did a lot of marketing, and I think the other FMCG companies are wondering that what do we do to cope up with that kind of challenge? Changing work and, I mean, changing business environment, dynamic. What comes up today, they could not even fathom a yogi sitting out there would give them a challenge of this capacity. They did not. But that's a reality now. And they'll have to come up with something more innovative, something more creative. They want to stay relevant. Correct? So, to answer your question, whether it's right or wrong, I will not directly say that maybe it is relevant on that aspect, but is it the only way? Probably not. Any other questions?
Thank you, ma'am, for enlightening us with your words of wisdom. You spoke about the changes in the business.